Welcome back to the IBSP. Here's your host, Foxy New.
Welcome back, Fight fans. Welcome back. Jose Ramirez defeats Victor Postol in what a lot of people are calling a controversial decision. Let's see if it's actually controversial. When you look at the fight and you break it down, the first thing you do, you know, is a lot of people simply don't understand how to judge a fight. And when you judge a fight, there's three things that you really look at on the first. You know, the first thing is you look at ring generalship, you know, who's using the art of footwork, you know, making use of the ring, you know, just pretty much doing all the things right, all the small, subtle things. Ring generalship is one. Hard and clean punching, you know, who's getting the harder punches, the cleaner shots through, who's doing that? And then the third and final thing is simply defense. You know, is your defense on par? Are you doing enough defensively? Those are the three things that you really need to look at when you judge a fight. And when you see this fight from the very beginning, you saw, you know, Jose Ramirez, you know, come out. And he was putting outstanding pressure on Victor Postol early in the fight. Then Postol came back and was just putting a lot of work in on him with the jab. You know, and when you look at it, you saw it was a very close back and forth type of affair. You know, one round, you know, Jose Ramirez would come in and put an adequate amount of pressure on Postol, hurt him with different shots. But you also see Postol stayed in the fight by constantly jabbing, constantly countering and landing that right hand. One thing that could have affected Jose Ramirez as well, maybe he was overworked. You know, when you look at what he's done, he had 100 plus rounds of sparring. He had 8 plus months in the making of this particular fight. He had over 3 training camps because the fight kept being delayed. So you see, you know, these guys had a lot to put in and they were ready for this fight. But at the same time, it doesn't change the fact that this fight was very close. Both of these guys has great trainers, you know, Freddie Roach, Hall of Fame trainer, Robert Garcia, Hall of Fame trainer. So I respect both of the guys, both of the camps. When we really break it down, I had this fight a draw personally. It could have went either way. I don't think it was a robbery because for it to be a robbery, you know, you would have to have a clear, definitive winner. You would have to have one guy who clearly beat the other guy. And I don't think either guy did that. But I think, you know, if you gave it to Postol, I wouldn't be mad. If you gave it to Ramirez, I simply wouldn't be mad. I could see the fight going either way. I think a draw would have been fair, but I have no problem with, you know, Jose Ramirez winning the fight. I think it's a fair decision either way it goes, simply because it could have been a draw, which means there's a lot of swing rounds. You know, judging was all over the place. But when you judge, when you make your scorecard, do not get on a fanboy tirade. Understand ring generalship, the harder, cleaner punches, and defense. You know, Jose Ramirez simply didn't have any defense in this fight. None. Victor Postol had the defense. Victor Postol had the ring generalship. But Jose Ramirez also had the cleaner, harder punches throughout. And he also hurt Postol multiple times in this fight. Postol did hurt Ramirez in the 10th round, I believe. So this was really a type of fight that could have went either way, could swing either way. And this is what I've learned about this fight. I've learned that Postol's not done. But I've also learned that Jose Ramirez may have been overrated to a degree because, you know, when he faces a guy like Josh Taylor, Regis Progre, or even if he wins and moves up and faces a guy like Terrence Crawford, his lack of, you know, diversity offensively, his lack of defense, all of these things is going to hurt you when you face a big puncher, when you face a crafty boxer. He must evolve his game with more than just pressure. But once again, unbiased as always, it's the IBFP.